In this vlog, we will see how to create an alert dialog using our GetX library. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen how to create a snack bar using the GetX library. And if you have missed the tutorial, I am providing the link in the description section below. And now the first requirement is we need to add the get dependency here. So the current version is 4.1.4, and by adding it to the dependencies, tap on the pub get button here. And here our plugin will be successfully downloaded. And now let's start with our coding part. So let's import material.dart and also get.dart. So these are the two imports we required in this particular tutorial. So now specify void main, and here consider our default class myApp. So we do require a stateless widget here, and now return a get material app. So from here our coding part starts for our GetX components. In our general scenario, we will be specifying a material app here, but we do require a get material app here to make use of our GetX dependency. So inside which provide this scaffold, and inside this scaffold we again have app bar and body specifications. So these are all the general things we see almost in every application. So then specify the body part here. So I am considering a column, and here inside the children let's specify a text button, and these are the two default requirements required for a button. And for the child, I am specifying a text widget which provides a text dialog. And inside onPress, let us specify our get default dialog. So here you can see, and specify a title for it. So I'm specifying sample dialog, and now specify the title here. So you can just specify it like sample dialog. So now let's try to run our code and see the output. And yes, our code is now successfully built, and here you can see the output. We have got a dialog to the top left here. So let's make it to the center of the screen. And now inside the column, specify the main axis alignment to center. And here we go, we got it to the center of the screen here. So when you tap on this button here, you can see we got a sample dialog. And also you can see here we just got a sample content, but we have not specified any content, but we have got this. And there is no button to just quit the dialog. You can just tap anywhere else for now. So now let's get started how this default dialog works and what we can do here. And one more thing I just want to specify for the beginners here, don't forget to add get material app here. So if you have not specified get here, and when you try to run the code here, you can see you will not be able to open the dialog, and you will be getting some sort of errors here. So I'm just specifying it. Don't forget to add the get material app here, by which our get library will start executing. So here these are all the parameters we have for our default dialog. So we have considered title now, and we have provided a title, and we have not used any of this still. Let's get into the documentation once. And here you can see what we got is this particular line, right? dialog made in three lines of code. So let's provide the text here for the middle text. Your content goes here. So this is what the sample content, and yes, we got our content here. And now what about the buttons? So we have got some buttons here. So let's try them, confirm and cancel button. Let's add a cancel button, and for which I'm going to specify a text quit. And here you can see we got a button quit, and when you tap on it, your dialog will automatically get dismissed. And you can see we have not provided any coding for cancel, but yet our dialog is being closed when you tap on the quit button. But don't think that every button will make the dialog dismiss. So let's see, text confirm, and here let's provide OK. And now try to run the code here. So now we got the OK button here, and when you tap on the OK button, nothing happens. So just for the cancel button only, the dialog will get dismissed. And so this is a basic functionality we do expect from any alert dialog. So yes, these are all the custom data, but when you want to make your own customizations here, just you want to provide your own style, you want to provide something more than what is available here. So just make use of their parameters. And one more thing, mostly people will like to have a dismissible alert dialog. By default, it is dismissible alert dialog itself. So here, when you tap anywhere else on the screen, the dialog will get dismissed. So now let's make it false and try to run the code and see. Now we are not able to close our dialog when you tap outside of the dialog. So you need to just tap on the quit button to dismiss the dialog. And what are all the other parameters? Now let's try to use the radius, and just I'm trying to provide 50 to just make you understand that how radius works. So here when you provide 50 here, you can see our corner radius is now set to 50, and just tap on the quit button. And also you can provide your functionality for these buttons here. So for example, for confirm button, so for confirm button, I want to quit the dialog. So yes, you can do the same here. Provide the functionality here. So get dot back. And now when you tap on the confirm button, that is OK button here, our dialog gets dismissed. And to handle the cancel button, you can just make use of on cancel and provide your coding in between the curly brackets. Let's do something more now. So instead of middle text, I just want a widget that goes here. So let's provide a widget here, and let's make it like get content and return a text widget. So here just provide the same message here, your content goes here, and provide the semicolon, and just make use of this get content here. So instead of this, there is a parameter called content here, and for which you can assign our widget get content. And once see the output, you are getting your content goes here, a single line here, right? And now let's make use of this widget now, and just we will try to make some difference here. So I'm specifying widget, and now try to run the code. Your content goes here widget. So now our content is being received from the widget and not from this middle text parameter. And you can ask me, what is the advantage of doing so? So here in the middle text, this accepts only a string value here, and when you want to add more number of lines to your content, so for example, let's try to wrap it inside a column, and you can add multiple lines of code here, And now try to run this code, and here you have got a 4 lines of content in your dialog. So isn't it a great way of doing so? I also want to customize the buttons here. I just don't want to add it here, like text cancel and text confirm and the functionality in this way. So what I will do is, like, I will specify widget. So for confirm button, I am going to make a widget like this and return an elevated button this time. And in the on press, let's specify our functionality. And here for the child, I'm going to specify a text called confirm. And inside the on press, currently I'm not specifying any functionality here. Let's close this. Let's copy and paste it for cancel button too. And cancel. So for the cancel button, let's provide the code get.back. And for the time being, let's provide the same code here also, get.back, which will dismiss the dialog. And here confirm, and provide the confirm button here, and cancel, provide the cancel button widget which we have just created. And here you can see we have provided quit and OK. And now try to refresh the code and see the output now. So we have got confirm and confirm. Why? Because we have provided the same text here. So this time I will provide cancel here. And now let's try. So we have got cancel and confirm here. So yes, even you can provide your own customized widget here instead of making use of the default parameters which are provided in the default dialog here. And also there are few more things here. You can change the text color. I think you can just make them. And also we have discussed almost everything. So yes, if you are having any queries still, do let me know in the comment section below. And I hope you understood how the default dialog works and how you can create a simple dialog using GetX library. So the code for this tutorial will be available in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.